In general, you have a matrix A that you would like to make into an upper triangular matrix. To do that, you apply a whole bunch of permutations and Gauss transforms. But the net result is the same as if you had performed all of these permutations up front. Notice that if you multiply a whole bunch of permutations together, inherently you get a new permutation. And the result then is a lower triangular matrix and an upper triangular matrix. Now, what does that mean? What this means is that if you want to solve AX equals B, what you want to do is apply the same permutations to the right-hand side as you did to the matrix A. That way, the equality remains because you've multiplied both sides by the same matrices from the left. And then you find out that this whole mess right here is now actually the LU factorization that has overwritten our matrix A. And therefore, what you want to do is you want to take your right-hand side matrix B, apply the same permutations to it up front, and then do the same forward and backward substitution stages that we had created for LU factorization before. In other words, you want to solve with a unit lower triangular matrix and then solve with an upper triangular matrix. What does that mean? Well, let's put things side by side. On the left here, what we have is the algorithm that performs LU factorization with partial pivoting. Had the right-hand side vector been available, then you would have also applied the same permutations to that right-hand side vector. Because they were not available up front, what you have to do is create a routine into which you feed in the permutation vector that was computed by the LU with partial pivoting algorithm. That then permutes your right-hand side in exactly the same way as if it had been part of an appended system. And then all you have to do is do your forward and backward substitution. So here is a closer look at that algorithm. All you do is you march through your right-hand side vector B, you march through your pivot vector P that came out of the LU with partial pivoting algorithm, and at each stage you permute the elements of the remainder of the vector of B in exactly the same way that you permuted the corresponding rows of A at the same corresponding stage in the LU with partial pivoting algorithm. So in summary, the LU factorization can be modified to incorporate row swapping, which we call partial pivoting. Solving AX equals to B then means that you compute your LU factorization as well as this vector that tells you how the rows of A were pivoted along the way. You then update your right-hand side vector, and then you do your forward substitution, and you do your back substitution. Now, if this process does not break down, you then have another way for this class of matrices solve AX equals B for any right-hand side B. What does it mean for the process not to break down? Well, you still cannot encounter a zero that ends up in your upper triangular matrix U. So what it means is that at every point when you need to decide whether you need to swap rows, as long as you can find a row with which to swap so that you end up with a non-zero on the diagonal, you're okay and the process continues. What we will look at next week is what to do if this process breaks down, or what the implication is if this process breaks down.